Shalom, shalom. This is the Brother Amma One coming in the spirit of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, with another lesson, giving all the praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Hashem, Rakhakudash. As always, double honors goes to the apostles, our apostles, and our elders of Great Millstone who rule well. And blessings unto all you brothers out there that's doing this work in the name of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai, in these last days. Excuse me. So yeah, just wanted to do this quick lesson. Yeah, man, because these times are, as you can see in the title of this article here, UK fruit banks under record pressure. So the fruit banks are what you know, what certain charities and supermarkets allow to set them up to give food to the needy. So the general public will donate food, or particular shops and whatever, you know, services might donate food that is not, you know, surplus, or, you know, maybe going however it's used by date in a, you know, matter of days or whatever. And yes, so basically it's there to help the needy, right? So, you know, basically it's just a food charity, right? But now they're saying it's under pressure, man. Why? Because this cost of living crisis, that is this so-called cost of living crisis that these corporations are pushing the average people into, is hitting the pockets, man. So it says UK food banks under record pressure. Almost 90% of those surveyed have seen soaring demand, according to the Independent Food Aid Network. So it says the UK food banks are being overwhelmed by an unprecedented increase in demand increase in demand amid double-digit inflation and the cost of living crisis, new research has found. According to the survey published on Sunday by the Independent Food Aid Network, an institution uniting more than 550 independent food banks, 89% of organizations have seen a rise in the number of people seeking support in December and January as compared to the same period 1 year ago. Things are reaching that peak, man, you know. And this is what they want. Why? So they can get you on that universal basic income, man. They want to control, they've always wanted to control not just the money, but the food. And how, what food you're buying. That's why they're always talking about this veganism and people eating bugs. You know, fake meat. You know, documentaries on the carbon emissions from the cows, man. You know? It says, moreover, over 80% of food banks reported that many Britons who were asking for help were doing so for the first time in their lifetime. See? So people that are used to being able to go to the supermarket and just spend their money on their shopping and that, it's hitting them hard now, man. This is not people that, you know, have always been on a breadline, so to speak. You know, these are now people that it's hitting the people now that actually even have jobs. It says about 50% of the organizations covered in the survey also said that if demand increased, they would be forced to cut the volume of assistance or to refuse some applicants altogether. The document attributed these developments mainly to increases in the cost of living. These have been spurred by skyrocketing inflation and soaring energy prices, exacerbated by the sanctions the West imposed on Russia over the Ukraine conflict. Other reasons include inadequate wages and the waiting time needed to receive a first social security payment from authorities, as well as benefit deductions. And those benefits are something that they're trying to get rid of, man, so they can have that one benefit system. A warning that the current situation is unsustainable what does that mean again? So like, where was that? Independent Food Aid Network. So the Independent Food Aid Network urged the UK government to increase social security assistance to match the rising day-to-day costs and to eliminate the 5-week waiting period to receive the first social security check. While in recent months, inflation in the UK has somewhat eased up, as of January, it still amounted to 10.1%. Meanwhile, food inflation reached 16.7% in the same month. Against the backdrop earlier this month, the National Institute of Economic and Social Research claimed that UK households were suffering a permanent reduction in living standards amid the crisis. It also warned that 7 million or 1 in 4 British households will be unable to fully cover their energy and food bills from this April when the government starts scaling back its subsidies programs. See, imagine that. So in the peak times now that money's tight and energy's costing a lot of money, inflation on food and all of that stuff, and they don't want to start scaling back the subsidies, man, which means the benefits. See, they're pushing the populace into the corner, man, right? You know, the digital cash is coming, that CBDC is on its way. You know, so that CBDC, when it comes, you will only be able to spend that CBDC where they tell you and on what food they tell you. So there's the control with the money and the food, man. You know, so let's get into a few scriptures anyway. Because, you know, people are walking around still thinking. In fact, hold on a second. I'm not going to read this, but there is another article actually that was going into the food situation. Oh, when it's still here. Maybe it's not here anymore. Let me try here. If I can't find it, I can't find it, you know. So it works sometimes, but yeah, here it is. I won't read all of this, but it says, global food giant issues grim warning. Nestle expects prices for staple items to keep on rising in 2023. So the world's biggest food corporation, Nestle, has said prices for staple items will continue to grow during 2023 after more than a year of price increases have forced the ordinary consumer into an ongoing struggle to buy groceries. I might do another lesson on this, but so I'm not going to read all of that. But the point is that, you see, this is a corporation. And I remember years ago, I don't know if he still works with him, but there was a CEO of Nestle, and he said that he believes water is not a human right. So it shows you what they're really thinking, man. If they think water's not a human right, what do they think about the food? Because you can survive longer without food than you can without water. You know, probably 20 odd days you can survive without food. Water is a week, if that. So there's a plan here. These are companies that are making profits. If you're the biggest corporation, food corporation, you're making profits hand over fist, man. There's no doubt about that. So, like, and let me just excuse me, Sadaka, for that. Yeah, let's get back into that. So, yeah, what was I saying now? So, yeah, you know, if they're making money hand over fist, man, there's no doubt. So, you know, why are they increasing these prices? Because it's hitting the pockets. Anyway, let's get into the scriptures, man. So, 1 Thessalonians 5:1, it says, but the times and the seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you, for yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. Because these are all precursors. We're in the day of the Lord, man. You know, because you got to think about it like this. One day to the Lord is like 1,000 years, man. So we're in the last day of the Lord, man. It says, for when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them as a travail upon a woman with child, they shall not escape. So that peace and safety is on its way out, man. No one's sure. Everybody's unsure of the future. Everybody's unsure, you know, whether they're going to be working in the next few months, or whether they're going to be able to afford to pay their gas bills or their electricity bills, or put food on the table, or pay their rent. You know, and most people are covering up these worries, man. They're going about their day-to-day lives, as you know, with their heads in the sand like ostriches, not really understanding how deep this is going to be. Because this isn't affecting the elites at all. This isn't affecting your government officials and all of that, and your corporation owners, man. It's not affecting them. When they're telling you to, you know, to tighten up your belts and stop eating this and don't buy that, they're not doing that, man. And their plan is to not do that. Their plan is to have you under the cosh, have you eating bugs and vegan, fake vegan foods, while they're sitting eating steaks, you know, and all of that other stuff, man. You know, they plan to live it large while they plan for you to live, you know, hard. So yeah, peace and safety, man, is coming to an end. It says, but ye brethren are not in darkness, that ye shouldn't that they should overtake you as a thief. Ye are all the children of light and the children of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. So this is one of the signs, man. We have to be mindful of these signs, man. You know, you got people that are working that go into these, you know, maybe have two, three jobs, a main job and a couple of side jobs, and they go into these food banks, man. You know? Second Ezra 16 and 17 says, woe is me, woe is me. Who will deliver me in those days? The beginning of sorrows. And great mournings, the beginning of famine. See, the key word there is famine, man. And great death. You know, great famine is going to bring great death, man. People are going to be dying of starvation at some point, you know. There's no cannibalism is going to come back into play, man. You think that's not going to happen? People are going to eat whatever they can eat, man. It happened to the children of Israel, man. It happened in Jerusalem in the sacking of Jerusalem, in 70 AD, man. That was prophesied that we would eat our own children, man. It says, the beginning of wars and the power shall stand in fear. The beginning of evils, what shall I do when these evils shall come? Behold, and there's that word again, famine, and plague, tribulation, and anguish are sent as scourges for a remnant. But for all these things, they shall not turn from their wickedness, nor be always mindful of the scourges. Behold, victuals shall be so good, cheap upon earth. You know? That's how people are thinking right now. Because they don't understand. There's people out here that are still spending their money like it's going to last forever. Not understanding. And there's people out here struggling, starving, you know, stealing, going to food banks to eat. You know, every time I turn around when I'm on my travels, man, there's someone on a step or on a pavement begging for change, man. And this is a so-called civilized world, the Western world, man. A first world, apparently. But you got cats on the street, you know, begging for money, man. Sleeping on the streets in the dead of winter. You know, and as if you was a ruler of this country, that would be, that should bring shame. But this is what these people want. These elites don't give a damn about you, all right? It says that they shall, it says, behold, victuals shall be so good cheap upon earth that they shall drink themselves to be in, think themselves to be in good case, and even then shall evils grow upon earth, sword, famine again, and great confusion. For many of them that dwell upon earth shall perish of famine, and the other that escape the hunger shall the sword destroy. And the dead shall be cast out as dung, and there shall be no man to comfort them, for the earth shall be wasted, and the cities shall be cast down. So shall there be no man left to till the earth and to sow it. You know? And that's another part of their plan, man. You got Bill Gates out there buying up the whole of America, man, so he can control, you know, the outlands, you know, world of, you know, so you can't grow food there. You got Monsanto, which is one of them evil corporations, taking over people's farms, man, growing their Franken food, man, their GMO foods. That's the future that these people have in mind for you. I'm going to jump down to verse 35. It says, hear now these things and understand them, ye servants of the Lord. Behold the word of the Lord, receive it. Believe not the gods of whom the Lord bespake. Behold, the plagues draw nigh and are not slack. And that's, and famine is a part of the plagues, man. That's a plague. I'm going to jump around a bit. So it says, verse 43 says, he that soweth as if he should not reap, also he that reapeth the vineyard, or the vineyard, some people say vineyard, as he shall not gather the grapes. Right? Verse 45 says, and therefore they that labor in vain, for strangers shall reap their fruits and spoil their goods, overthrow their houses and take their children captives, for in captivity and famine shall they get children. So imagine, it's wicked times, man. People are going to rob you for what you've got to eat, and they're going to take your children. What do you think they're going to take your children for? What, to raise them? How are they going to do that when they're taking your food? They're taking your children to do evils upon them, and to probably to, you know, to feed upon them, man. And that's just the truth. One here, Ecclesiasticus in, or Sirach in the Apocrypha 39:29 says, fire and hail and famine and death were all these were created for vengeance. So this is punishments, man, that are coming upon the earth, you know. And there's another one, Ecclesiasticus 40:9, it says, death and bloodshed, strife and sword, calamities, famine, tribulation, and the scourge. These things are created for the wicked, and for their sakes came the flood. Right, so this is all punishment for the wicked, man. And I'm going to get a quick one for the prophets, man, because this isn't for us to worry about. This is the warnings that we're supposed to give out, man. But we ain't to worry about these things, man. All right? We're not supposed to be worrying about how we're going to eat in these days and you know, is the Lord going to feed us? No, man, that's a lack of faith, man. I'll just get to the point. Because this is what's going to be happening in these dark days, man. Isaiah 65 and 13 says, therefore, thus saith the Lord Yahweh, behold, my servants shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. That's talking to the wicked, not just the Edomites and the heathens, man, but the wicked of our people. Behold, my servants shall drink, but ye shall be thirsty. But ye shall be thirsty. Behold, my servants shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed. Behold, my servants shall sing for joy of heart, but ye shall cry for sorrow of heart, and shall howl for vexation of spirit. And we're going to be singing for joy of heart, right? Because we're going to be seeing all these evils done upon you wicked people out here. Knowing that we're in the times of our coming salvation from Yahweh Shai, man. Right? This is why we want to see these things. Not because we're sadistic and evil, but because it brings us closer to the coming of our Lord. All right. So, yeah, man. That's it. That's what I'm going to close out on that one, man. The Lord, when it was edifying, you know, dark times are coming, man. But for the prophets, man, those that believe and those that are of the elect, man, we haven't got to worry, man. Or I'll say of the hopeful elect, we haven't got to worry. All right. Yahweh Shai has got us, man. Okay. So, Lord, when this was edifying, and yeah, shalom until the next one.